Hi, so today's little exercise, I'm going to hike over to Church Farm in Ardley from Stevenage. I think I'm gonna do about a 14 kilometer route. I'm just trying to make it as long as possible, because what I'm training for is going to the Isle of Skye next year. So it's an itch I've wanted to scratch for a long time. I've been collecting the gear for over a long time, but it's something I've never just got round to yet. So yeah, basically I'm hiking to Church Farm in Ardley, about 14 kilometers, and I'm gonna camp there tonight. I'm carrying all my food and water, enough for 2 days of hiking and camping. And yeah, basically that's about it. I've got a 21 kilogram rucksack on my back, which sounds very heavy, but that's looking what I'm going to be carrying when I go to the Skye for my overnight wild camps and things. I might have to carry a lot of food and I might have to carry a lot of water, depending on whether I'm staying near water, going to camp near water or not. So this is the object of my mission today. The pack feels all right, it doesn't feel too bad. So I'm just going, cutting into Aston now, and gonna get out onto the paths. So hopefully it doesn't completely piss down with rain. It is forecast to rain quite a bit over the next couple of days, but hopefully we might miss a lot of it. It's a bit hit and miss whether the rain's gonna hit or not. So hopefully I'll miss any proper deluges while I'm walking over there, at least. So anyway, I'll see you in a bit. I've just sort of hiked through Aston and going for a farm out into the fields. My local trails are quite nice. I normally run around here quite regularly. Quite lucky to be living so near some nice trails, isn't it? With the horses. So I'm using the walking poles today, just because I'm carrying such a heavy pack, and it helps steady your balance and takes a bit of pressure off your knees. So I can't see anything wrong with that when you're carrying a 21.5 kilogram backpack. So that's the answer to that query. So just on the fields now, looking over the valley that cuts down through Aston with the river Bean. It's just starting to rain a bit, but I'm not sure if it'll rain too much for too long, so I'll hold off of putting my waterproofs on for the moment, because it might get a bit hot if I put my waterproofs on. I'm even carrying my heavyweight waterproofs, so yeah, it might get a bit hot and sweaty if I put them on, but I just wanted to take it because, you know, that's what I'm going to have to do in Scotland probably if I go in May next year. This year it was regularly dropping down below zero at night and blah, blah, blah. So, yeah, it's going to have to be like four season winter gear if I go up there next year. I'm going to have to take. So I wanted to experience what it was like. I didn't want to skimp on anything, so I did skimp on my sleeping bag actually, but my four season sleeping bag is very big and it's very big anyway, so I might have to buy a new more compact four season sleeping bag, so I can fit it all in my rucksack. I'll have to see about that, but yeah. So I decided to put my waterproofs on because I was thinking it is forecast to rain quite steadily today, so not showers. So it's not raining very hard. I mean, knowing my luck, it will probably stop raining in a minute anyway, and now I'll put my waterproofs on. But I thought I'm better off trying to keep the rain off a bit of everything, put my rain cover on my backpack, and just get going. Hopefully it won't be too hot and sweaty. And but the lovely cornfields here. So yeah, now just going to be walking along the River Bean in a minute. So yeah, just walking along the old River Bean. It's quite overgrown there now. It's getting quite overgrown these days. Very overgrown. But there is a bit of water in it at the moment. So just go through these nice horse fields. The little bridge and seat there that goes across the River Bean. No time to stop there today though, unfortunately. Have a little sit down. I've got to carry on my way. So here, this used to be a farm field, and now they've stopped farming it and they're just letting all the wild flowers grow. As you can see, it looks very nice with the wild flowers growing up, and they're letting people have allotments on here as well, and growing stuff on the allotments. So they've got a little dog training thing down the end there. I'll show you that in a minute as well. But you know what they've done with this little farm field here, letting people use it and stuff. It's quite good. There's some more allotments over the back there as well. So there's that dog training field I was talking about. Some people there now doing a bit of dog training or something like that. There's the Ford Lane Ford in Aston. But I'm going off this way, straight along the River Bean, until I get to the next ford along, and then I'm crossing over the ford and going up that way. Just coming to the end of the field, cross the road there in a minute, a little farm there, and then more fields going along the River Bean, following the River Bean still. So more fields here now. It's still been constantly very light rain, so I'm not feeling that stupid for putting my waterproofs on anyway, even though it is a bit hot. So it's all good training for getting up to Scotland, where it fucking pisses down a lot, as you well know. The old hay bales in the fields. Yes, so not too bad so far. The only thing, I'm a bit hot, that's the only thing, but nothing I can't handle. Pack feels a bit sort of cutting in my shoulders a little bit, but I'm not used to these walking poles as well, so that's probably making my shoulders feel a bit like that, but I'll have to get used to it anyway. So anyway, onwards. So this is that other ford, but as you can see, there is no water running through the river at the moment. So look at that. That's a miserable sight. But this, unfortunately, is what the River Bean often gets like in the summer. It dries up in the summer and then fills up again in the winter, and when it's in flood and things, and then dries up. So the River Bean is not much of a river no more. But there you go. So we're going just up there, and then a left at the top of the road, and then just a little way down there is right and back onto the footpaths again. So I will see you in a minute. So yeah, just cutting up now to Bennington, just crossing the Cotton Lane Bridleway there. That's the Cotton Lane Bridleway. But I am going off up there to Bennington. So the rain's getting a bit heavier now, but I got my waterproofs on, so no dramas. It's going quite well. The old straps are cutting in a little bit, but not, you know, not so much that it's bothering me that much. But I'm just getting my head down and, you know, concentrating on using the poles just to take the stress off it all. And it seems to be going all right, working quite well, even though it's raining. So yeah, that's the Cotton Lane Bridleway, goes up there. But I am going up this bridleway here that comes out up the top of Bennington. So, onwards. Hi, so I'm just getting into Bennington now. So I just thought I'd stop on this bench quickly. I've got a bit of a stone in my boot, so I think I'll try and get that out before I keep on walking. Make it a bit more comfortable. Don't want to get any horrible blisters from the stone. No point if I don't have to. And yeah, so I've been going about 2 hours 20 odd minutes and about 11.2k, and it's very wet and rainy. So out there, wet and rainy Bennington. So I'll just sort that out and then I'll be back on my way. There's the Bell pub in Bennington. It does say closed on the door, so I don't know if they're permanently closed now because of COVID. It's, you know, it's put an end to the pub, maybe. There's the Bennington Lordship over there, but I'm not going there. I'm going off up this way, straight through Bennington, and cut across through, I think it's through Clay End, and then across to Ardley, going down over the, from, over the back from Walken, and a little pond there with a nice lily pad flowers. Oh, so onwards. So going from Bennington to Clay End, there's a nice private road I'll cut through. So it's all gated off. Just walk through here, walk through the grounds. There's a, I think there's a care home down the bottom of here. But I'll show you in a minute. The cows have got scents over there, lying down in the field. Yeah, so this is the house here. I'm not sure whether it is a care home or not, I'm not sure. But I thought I did see a sign another time saying it was a care home. But, and there's a farm just there. So I'm just coming into Clay End now. So probably about another 4k going to Ardley or something like that, 3 or 4k. So getting there. I'm not sure yet, but I might be meeting my mate in the pub, which is at Ardley, for a pint when I get there. So that'd be nice if he comes over for a pint. It'll relieve some of the boredom of the day of solo camping on your own. But I'm going to try and have a good look around the farm as well. I've never been round Ardley Church Farm before in Ardley. So I've been past it plenty of times, but never actually been in there and looked around. So yeah, here's Clay End. Right, see you in a bit. Lovely little thatched cottage there. Very quaint Brer cottage. just down here, not too far to go, and my mate says he is meeting me for a pint when I get there, so that'd be nice. So I'm just more or less coming into the back of Ardley now, and you can just see Church Farm, the back of Church Farm from over there, the back of a few houses, but I think that's all the farmland there, that's all part of Church Farm. So they've got some nice trails around Ardley itself, very nice little trails to walk around Ardley if you ever do want to come there. It's a nice trip out to go to Ardley Church Farm to see all the animals and things, maybe a bit of camping yourself. They've got, I think they've got camping huts there as well, or you can use your own tent. You can have fires, you have to pay for a fire, but I don't think I'm going to do that. I mean, I've grown up doing, you know, camping outdoors in the wild and making my own fires, so I don't particularly, if I'm training to do backpacking, want to be paying someone to light a fire. It's not really my idea of good fun. Bit of a waste of money really. I've got no food to cook on the fire as well, on like on the fire pit, so what's the point in it? But yeah, down there they must be pig fields, just there you can see, or I can see them, I don't know if you'll be able to see them on the GoPro. Pig fields, they look like pig tin huts. So we'll be in Ardley in just a minute. So there's some very old houses in Ardley, as you can see. There's some people working on that house there, look, thatching the roof in the rain. I wouldn't have, well no, no, not thatching the roof, they're doing the chimney, the brickwork on the chimney, actually. Yeah, so I suppose they can do a little bit of brickwork in the rain. Yeah, so very old. There's the church there. St. Lawrence Church. Nice little pond. Nearly at the pub. So there we are, Church Farm Ardley, shopping cafe. Slow down. Ardley Parish Council. We are here in Ardley. And there's the Jolly Wagoner pub up there, where I'm meeting for a pint. Hey. So, it took me about 3 hours, 30 minutes, which is more or less exactly what I guesstimated, how long it would take me to get here. And I was right, but I didn't exactly guesstimate the distance, because it's about 10 miles, just over 16K, 16.818K. So, it's not bad. It's ended up a couple of kilometers more than what I guesstimated, but that's because I started off from a different point and I didn't know the distance from there to pick up the route, so that's why I got that wrong. But here we are, the Jolly Wagoner pub. Hey, so I will see you in a bit when I'm in the campsite and sorting my tent out and things like that. See you later. Hi, so yeah, I'm in Church Farm. I got checked in and basically I'm in the field. I didn't realise I should have booked the woodland camping, because I think it's a bit more secluded. So I've got to camp in this field. And I'm just walking around trying to find somewhere that's flat, because I ate nothing worse than camping somewhere that's not flat. So I'm just having a good walk around and trying to see the flattest place I can find, basically. But yeah, there's lots of people here camping, but you know, it is what it is. I'm not too bothered anyway, but let's go and see what this sign says over here. Private area, Lucy Stevens, they can't camp there. I might camp up there. It looks a bit more flatter up there, so let's go and camp up the back there. Anyway, I'll see you in a minute when I'm getting my camp set up. Right, so I found this spot here. It's So I think it's quite flat, it's not too uneven and it's not too sloping. So yeah, I'm gonna pitch my tent this way, I think, because the wind's blowing that way. So I want to get some nice airflow into my tent coming from that way. But in the night, the wind's gonna change around and then start blowing from this direction. So if I put my tent facing that way and then it will still get some airflow coming from the other direction in the night when the wind moves as well. I think that's what I'm doing anyway, so I'll see you in a minute. There you go, I've set the old Van Gogh Banksy 300 up, and I think I got it set up all right. So now I've just got to get my sleeping mat and all that set up in there nicely, and then I think I'm gonna go and walk around the grounds a bit before I have a bit of something to eat and that. So yeah, let's get this set up then. Right, so I've got everything set up there, my bed, my pillow, I've got my summer sleeping bag here, I've got my thermal mat, so I'm just trying it out, and I've now got this Trekology Luft AL UL50, so I think it's 50 mil basically, 5 centimeters thick. I've got that first night tonight with that, and I've got the Trekology pillow as well, the Trekology pillow there as well underneath. So yeah, I'm gonna give this a check out tonight, and got my stove and all that there, beer. So yeah, I think what I'm gonna do now is just have a little walk around, go and use the toilet first, have a little walk around the campsite. So yeah, so let's go and check out the campsite now, leave the tent. So I think this bit is called the walnut orchard, and they've got chickens in here and lots of walnut trees. Yeah, so free range laying hens. So I don't know where that goes down there. Wildlife area, no dogs walking. Oh, Pittswood, I think that's where they do camping in Pittswood. Anyway, let's go and see what else is up here. They got some sheep there, they're having a good old feed. Some more sheep there. Yes, look, say hello. Hello there. What we got, pigs over here, look. There's the pigs. Oh look, he's saying hello, hello. I ain't got no food for you though, unfortunately mate, I didn't buy them. You're hungry though, aren't you? Oh look, there's some spotted ones over there. Spotted pigs. Oh well, see you later. I'm gonna go and walk down here. I think there's some cows over. There's a big old ball there. And some cows as well. That must have been where I was walking down the path there earlier. I don't know if there's much else to see now. He's a big old pig, this one. He wants feeding, but I ain't got nothing for him. That one lying in there, look. Something I didn't see there, there's some goats. They're funny things with them floppy long ears, aren't they? Very funny. Sunny the Sunbeam Fairy. That must be the house that Sunny the Sunbeam Fairy lives in. Looking by it. Well, that's about it. All there is to see around Church Farm, I think. I don't know, I'm going to go and have a little walk up the other bit there, but I don't know exactly what there is to see around there. I think it's just a bit of woods in that. So anyway, I'll go and have an explore, see if I find anything. See you in a minute. Hi, so I walked around the farm and now I'm back in the tent. I decided to get out of all my wet clothes because I was quite sweaty from wearing the waterproofs and that, and wet underneath. So this is what happens when you go out hiking, especially in the mountains and that. It rains a bit and you put waterproofs on, but you get really wet from sweat. So I put some nice dry warm clothes on and I thought I'd give my feet a bit of an airing. Sorry to show you my feet there. So yeah, I think I'm now just gonna sit here and have a bit of a cook up. But I'm quite pleased with the old Van Gogh Banksy tent because I could get changed very easy. I've got another old tent that I've had and I used to have all sorts of problems getting changed. But you can sit up quite comfortably in here and move around. It's got plenty of room. So it's really good so far. So yeah, now I think I'll just get all the cookware set up and cook something to eat. So there's me cooking system there, cooking away. I've got me a chili con carne with rice, Expedition Foods. So yeah, you just boil 500 ml of water and then chuck it in there, mix it all up well and then seal it, and it cooks in about 5 to 8 minutes. So that should be good. Right, so that looks like it's boiling away there now. Boiling away nice there now. So let's turn it off. Let's turn it off. And let's pour this water in there. Steamed up a bit there, maybe on the old GoPro. So that's it, basically. You just gotta mix it all up and then seal it up. So the old chili con carne with rice is ready there. I might have overdone it with the water a little bit, but I don't think it actually ruins it, to be quite fair. It just makes it cook up a bit better. So, but it's very hot. I've already tasted it and it's very sort of spicy hot. So I'm gonna tuck into that now. So you definitely need one of these long spoons for these camping meals to get right down the bottom of it. Do you know what I mean? But they are quite expensive. I think it was about £7, that spoon, for a little plastic spoon. £7, I thought, was a lot of money. Right, so it's 3:20 in the morning and it's thundering lightning. So good test for the old Banshee. First day out in the Banshee and it's thundering lightning. What about that? I'm just sitting here hoping that it don't come crashing down on me, the old lightning. So you know, there's plenty of other people camping here with me as well though, so. But yeah, hopefully it'll be all right, but hopefully it won't be raining too hard for too long as well, and too much thunder and lightning. So, but anyway, I'll see you at first light or whatever. Hi, so it's just gone 6 in the morning. The rain has stopped a bit. It's very light rain now, but I mean, it was bucketing down for hours, but yeah, it's pretty eased off a bit now. So I'm just cooking up a bit of porridge. Oh, have a porridge and a coffee, and then I'll see about trying to get packed up and making a move back off home again. So it ain't been bad really, but yeah, it sort of, I had quite a good kip before it started pissing down at 3 o'clock, so it weren't bad really. And this new Trekology Luft roll mat with the foil mat on top has absolutely been really comfortable to sleep on. So I mean, it's a lot better than the Van Gogh mat I've got for comfort. So I mean, obviously it's a bit lightweight, it's probably not as durable, but it's done really well, so I'm really pleased with that. So instead of buying camping meal porridge, I bought just Tesco's porridge, 35p a pot for cherry porridge or berry porridge, whatever it is. What is it? Berry and cherry porridge, 35p a pot, and the camping ones are £5 a bag. So I bought two of them for like 70p then or whatever. What a saving that is, eh? Yeah, and I bought some Kenko instant 3-in-1 coffee, so got a bit of sugar in it, but for instant coffee, bit of sugar's probably a bit of a, makes it taste a bit better, doesn't it? Because it ain't that great at the best of times, is it? So, but yeah, quite nice. Right, so I've got all my walking gear back on, all my wet clobber for the walk home, and now I've got to pack up the tent. It started to rain again a bit, so I've got to get this tent packed up. I've never packed it up before when it's wet, so this is going to be a first. So I think I'm going to have to remove the inner and dry it all out a bit as I do it, and then pack it away like that and then dry it out again properly when I get home. So but it's not done too bad. It absolutely bucketed down last night and it hasn't really let any water in, so I'm quite happy with the old Banshee. Anyway, let's get this done. Hi, so yeah, I got packed away the tent for the first time in the wet. It weren't too bad. I took the inner out first, completely dried that to keep the inner as dry as I could because I don't want to get it too mucky. Rolled that away, packed it in the bag, and then I completely dried the outer and the ground sheet as much as I could, and then packed that away separately from the inner and then packed it all in a bag. So I think that's the best way to do it. And then when you get, say if you move on to another place, you're wild camping or you go to another campsite backpacking, then you have to get it all out and maybe give it another dry, quick dry again when you put it up, put the tent up and put the inner in. I think that's the best way to do it. But I got up at 6 o'clock, just gone six, five past six, and got out of the tent and went to the toilet and then started cooking my breakfast and all that, had my breakfast and coffees, and packed the tent away. It took me 2 hours, so it's not bad considering. So now hitting back on the road, gonna go a slightly different way, one of my normal routes, but a slightly different way from the way I come. But I think it'd probably be about 11k back to my house. So I think it's been a success, this little camping trip, this little backpacking camping trip. So bit of training got me used to what I'm doing, so let's hit the road. I'm now looking for a bin to dump this rubbish in, otherwise I've got to walk a fair way with it. I think I'll just chuck it in behind my rain cover and carry on walking. Anyway, I'm gonna get walking. I'll see you in a bit. So one good thing about going home is the pack's a lot lighter, because I've drunk two bottles of water, or used two bottles of water cooking and drinking coffee and all that, so it feels a fair bit lighter, which is nice. So, and it's not raining. I don't know if it's gonna rain. I haven't even bothered looking at the weather forecast yet, but I've still got my waterproofs on, thinking it might do, but it's not raining at the moment though. So just in walking, just cut through walking onto the bridle way that takes you up to into Stevenage, Great Ashby, and then into Stevenage. One thing about the campsite last night, it's not very flat for a start, so I did find quite a flat pitch, but it's not very flat anyway, the whole campsite. Got a lot of people around talking and making a lot of noise, so for me, I like to try and get my head down and get a bit of kip early when I'm tired, because sometimes you get woken up in the middle of the night, or I wake up early. You don't get might not get an incredible night's sleep anyway camping, even though I got quite decent, it was quite good last night, my bit of sleep I got. But yeah, so that was a little bit annoying for me. I mean, other people might not find it so annoying. And I've forgotten what else I was gonna say now. Oh yeah, sorry. And aeroplanes keep flying over. It's right on the flight path to Luton. So all night long you can hear aeroplanes flying over the pub, which also keeps you up a bit sometimes as well. So a few things about that campsite in Ardley. But you can, if you go there, you can choose to camp in the woods apparently, which I think might be a bit more quieter and a bit better than camping in the field. I don't know what the price difference is, but there you go. So just a few things I wanted to say about that campsite. But it seemed to be a lot of people there enjoying camping, so that was good. Anyway, off up the bridle way. I like this path. It's one of my favourite paths. It steadily climbs up a hill, and there's like a grassy grassy verge of a field that everybody uses as a path. It's strictly not the actual path, but everybody uses it. So it's quite good. Yeah, so this is what I was talking about. The path is actually there, but everybody walks up this nice grassy bit here, right next to the fields, and you get the nice views across the fields. It's always nice, and I always like training running up the hill. It always keeps me, gets me ready for these events with a hill running, running up here. So I've been going about an hour and a half now, about 6k, and I'm just coming into back of Great Ashby now. So I took my waterproofs off earlier. I didn't say that, but I did. So I don't think it is going to rain, and it's a bit cooler. I won't get so sweaty, which is always nice. So yeah, it's like a dank old misty morning sort of thing though, isn't it? Not very good visibility, but still, I'll get back in time for my Sunday dinner today, which is nice. I always like my Sunday dinner. Anyway, see you in a bit. So yeah, just got into Great Ashby really, as the houses, and then I take the path through the woods, just through this little patch of woods, and then that comes out in Great Ashby Park, cut through Great Ashby Park, and then into Boxwood. Yeah, so there's Great Ashby Park. People walking around, quite a few people about already. On into Boxwood. There's Boxwood. It's starting to brighten up a little bit now as well. And there's an Allied Mills bread bakery in Great Ashby. And you can smell the fresh cooked bread. Oh, it's beautiful. Nothing like the smell of fresh cooked bread, is it? So Boxwood. Always nice walking in Boxwood. Not sure which way I'll go. I think I'll go this way. So we've been going about nearly 10k. I've been into Stevenage and then back down into the fields in Aston, and I'm just coming down onto the way that I come when I come yesterday. So, and the sun is shining, so a bit of a happy ending to this story, this walk. So yeah, anyway, yeah, I think it's been a big success, this walk anyway, as a little training run. Good training for Scotland, being out in the thunder and lightning, because that's the sort of weather you probably get up in Scotland. could have done with a bit of wind to boot, maybe, just to spice it up a bit more, you know, training up a bit more. But anyway, there you go. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, see you later.